How's it going, Red Wings fans? It has been a rough time, going 2-8 in the 10 games since the priority patch has gone on. With two of those wins in the last three games, they will play the Islanders tonight, an Eastern Conference rival team who is looking to secure one of the wildcard spots in the conference. They are only 3 points back with the game in hand over the Red Wings. The free fall has led fans and probably management to look into bringing new faces to bring some life back into the team, namely two big NHL-ready prospects that have been waiting in Grand Rapids, Jonathan Berggren and Simon Edvinsson. Both players are top five on the Grand Rapids Griffins in scoring. Berggren sits first on the team by a large margin, and Edvinsson is the highest scoring defenseman on the team by a large margin as well. Not to mention owning one of the best plus minuses on the team, both are considered a big part of the team's success along with other players like Mazur and Kosa, who have been finding their game this season. Edvinsson and Berggren's success at the AHL level should be no surprise. Berggren played 67 games in the NHL last season, recording just short of 30 points, and many believed he earned a full-time spot. However, with the influx of talent coming onto the team in the offseason, Berggren was beat out for a spot and sent back down to the Griffins. Edvinsson may not have played as many games as Berggren, but the same general story applies to him too. Now is their time to shine. Berggren was called up quickly after the trade deadline when the Red Wings went to play the Vegas Golden Knights. He then played the following two games after against the Sabres and Coyotes, recording only one assist and was a minus five in that time, and hasn't seen NHL action since. To give Berggren credit, he did very well in his earlier call-up, getting 5 points in nine games, and aside from Raymond, pretty much everyone on the team is struggling right now. He seems pretty invisible on the ice when he has played, and obviously his results show that. Edvinsson has only been called up for one game so far against the Blue Jackets. In the game, he didn't record a point and was a minus one with 18 minutes and 36 seconds of ice time. However, it was a good first game. He was noticed and not noticed in the right ways. What I mean by that is that Edvinsson wasn't sticking out like a sore thumb, missing defensive cues, putting the puck in the wrong place, and aiding the other team more than his own, similar to how other people noticed Petrie and Sherratt. Rather, you notice him making small correct plays, moving the puck down the ice, and getting physical in the corners, similar to how we noticed Seider in his rookie season. Both players have a very small sample size to pull from this season, but both are good impressions. Despite Berggren's rough three games, Edvinsson looks responsible enough to take on heavier minutes in a second line role, not quite being in the bright lights, but also helping his team make it to the biggest stage in the NHL, the playoffs. Berggren will find his game. The question will be when. If it's this season or next year, regardless of when, he is going to be a great top 9 forward and power play guy for the Red Wings. What do you guys think? Let us know down below. And until next time, lights out in the Red Light District.